You find an XSS on an out of scope domain, you get this. It's common you stumble across an XSS on a subdomain of a company, but it doesn't have any impact. Well, it's not always the case. My friend, Sirius, found such a bug on Google Cloud AI Hub. One of the features is Jupyter Lab, which is a web-based interactive development environment that can run code. Google will install Jupyter Notebook on a VM instance and assign a random domain for it. Sirius noticed he could edit the HTML files of Jupyter by logging into the VM and get an XSS, but the domain is a sandbox domain, meaning it could only affect himself. He then noticed Notebook created by other users share the same parent domain, so he could use the XSS to force a cookie on the parent domain, which is allowed by SOP. All subdomains would then see that cookie. Naturally, he checked if this could bypass the CSRF protection of Jupyter. The way Jupyter Notebook mitigates CSRF is to compare the value of the XSRF cookie and the one in the header of a request. This is called the double submit cookie pattern. Unfortunately, it is not possible to include a custom header to a cross-origin request unless the website allows it via calls. Jupyter uses Tornado Web Server. Sirius checked the code and found that Tornado also accepts the CSRF token in the request body if it doesn't find it in the header. Now he had a CSRF. To exploit it, he just needs to use the XSS to write an XSRF cookie with a static value scoped to the parent domain. Then the CSRF protection can be bypassed because the value is fixed. This technique is called cookie tossing, because you toss cookies across domains. It is common to find and self-XSS on an out-of-scope domain or a sandbox domain, but it doesn't always mean a dead end. You can read more from my presentation in HitCon where I presented my research on cookie security. Link in the description.